Good morning, Kim Cramer from Saxo Bank in Copenhagen. Can you say something about the prediction of the euro dollar?
Well, the euro dollar is currently, well, we are below parity, right? And we're trading around the support area that's go back to, 30 years, around 96. And but if it takes out 96, then we're looking at spot 90, maybe even lower. And then we're really back to, actually before the euro dollar was established, or what the euro was established. But yeah.
So about the dollar is extremely strong this year. Do you think it will keep on strong this year?
Yeah, I mean, this is the year of the dollar, so I think it will continue. And against the euro, we can see it's, now it's we have euro again below parity around 96, but it can actually drop even further to 90, I believe, maybe even further. But around 90 towards the end of the year, I do believe that. But also against other currencies like the yen and especially the sterling, it's really, really strong at the moment. We have seen sterling against dollar to lowest level ever seen. I mean, we are below the 1985 levels. We are very close to parity there too. So it's going to be interesting towards the end of the year for that one.
Now back to equities. The S&P 500 did some corrections, of course, the last months or this year because of the invasion from Russia, of course, and many other things. But still, many equity markets are still on record levels when you see it historically. Would you recommend investors still to buy equities?
Well, they have to be very careful of what they're looking into or what they're considering buying. Of course, there's also something that's doing better than others, especially high dividend payment paying companies. They're doing better than the rest of the market. But in general, the overall market, I don't think we are there yet. At the moment, we can see we are just having a little pause here, especially on the S&P 500, around 3600. So it's we will maybe have a little bit of correction here now, but I see going into the rest of the year we could see 3,500, maybe even 3,200 on S&P.
Okay, when we look at the 10 years U.S. Treasury, what's your view on that?
Well, we are very close to 4%, actually, very, very close to 4% on the U.S. 10-year. So that's really interesting, something we have forecast for quite some time. And just this morning, I also looked at a future, because that's the deciding one, of course. And it's really at a support level at the moment. But I believe the future can be sold off even more. And we also have it in our Q3 outlook that is coming out here next week, where I actually say, well, 4% is actually more like a psychological level than a real, resistance level. So 4.3% in the euro dollar, in the US 10-year interest rates here in Q4 is quite likely.
Okay, and in the 1980s we saw 10% maybe for the US Treasury, also in Europe. Could you imagine maybe with high inflation keeping on remaining that US Treasury could raise way farther above 4%?
Interest rate, yeah, I think it can. I think we can get higher. We can get much higher, maybe even up to 5%. I mean, from my chair, from a technical perspective, I don't have any strong resistance on the U.S. 10-year until around 5.25.
Okay, thanks for the interview.
Thank you.